The Highlight team has extensive Next.js experience, so we've possibly gone a little overboard to make Highlight easy to use with Next.js. To get started, we'll kick off an npm install or yarn add for the necessary packages. While we wait for those modules to install, let's inject some environment variables into our Next.js app. We'll use a .env file to configure Highlight, and we'll export the environment from a constants.ts file. We'll be using these constants throughout our integration, so it's helpful to have a single, easy to import source. Notice that we're using TypeScript for this codebase. The process is identical for JavaScript codebases. Just replace .ts files with .js files and you're in business. Our next step is to update our next config to enable source maps and server-side instrumentation. Open next.config and set instrumentation hook and production browser source maps to true. Highlight also supports private source maps, which we've documented fully on highlight.io. Search for Next.js walkthrough. Now we can instrument our web client. We'll need to inject Highlight init into our app layout, which takes different forms for the page and app router systems. For app router, it goes in the layout render function. For page router, you'll add it to your underscore app render function. And that's it. The web client integration is complete. Now for the server. Next has two routing systems as of March 2023, the original page router and the newer app router. If you're starting a new Next.js codebase, just stick with the app router. It's the future of Next.js. App and page router can be used side by side, with page router routes defined in your pages directory and app router routes in the app directory. So let's wrap any page router API endpoints that we might have. You'll need to create a custom with highlight function and use it to wrap each of your endpoints individually. This step enables Highlight to detect back-end errors in these functions. Next, we'll instrument the app router. Because we enabled instrumentation hook in our next.config file, Next.js will call instrumentation.ts every time it starts or restarts a server process. This gives us an easy hook into the runtime. But be warned, instrumentation.ts can be called in Node.js incompatible runtimes, so we have to be careful to only run Node packages in the Node.js runtime. Now we can call registerHighlight within our register function. The registerHighlight function will forward all errors to Highlight servers, completing our server-side integration. Now, if you happen to be deploying to Vercel, we need to warn you that Vercel's Edge runtime does not support Highlight. You can specify the Node.js runtime to avoid this limitation. This is due to the restrictions built into the Edge runtime. We expect to work around these restrictions in a future release. The client and server side of our Next.js app are now fully instrumented, so let's track some sessions and throw some errors to test the integrations. If you're not seeing sessions, double-check your project ID to make sure you've injected it successfully into your application code. And if you're still having trouble, hit us up on the Highlight Discord. We'd love to help you troubleshoot and get your integration on track. Also, let us know if you discover any issues at all with this tutorial. We're committed to an easy, satisfying experience for all Highlight users.